Hi there, my name is Austin Willis, and I will be going through just a little bit of a tutorial regarding the BeyondTrust remote support system that we use here at OSM in order to be able to conduct remote installations and software changes. I guess to get started, this link here that you see in the browser, this itsupport.usgs.gov/login/pre_login_agreement is a resource that you're going to want to bookmark and keep for yourself. While this is the kind of browser login portion of things, and there is a desktop version that you can log into every time you get on your system, this is certainly a great resource to have. And I'll show you why, because there's additional downloads and things available here that you won't find in the desktop console. So you're going to start off by selecting accept. Well, okay, here we go. Sorry, and hung up for just a moment. And it's going to give you two options here. You can either log in with the username and password, or you can use this SAML authentication. And that's what we're going to do here. To be able to access it. So a couple things you should note right off the bat. Hopefully your name is here. If not, well, you might have bigger issues. But if you're not able to log in, we have some great support on this, and you can certainly reach out and we can kind of forward you along to those personnel. But yeah, like I said, kind of want to start here, make sure that your credentials pulled appropriately. So I'm going to kind of work around this website real quick, show you some things along the way. So you have this jump option here. I don't use this very often, but you can. It's just different kind of means to be able to create like a mass deployment system, which again, we don't typically use, especially within the confines of TIPS. If you're a system administrator and do things across the network, may be useful for you in some regards. And then show you this rep console. These are canned scripts that can be run. Again, way more often than not, these are typically used for true like IT system administrators as opposed to the TIPS admins, but they're there just for your awareness. This, which we're not gonna select yet, will actually launch a web version of the representative console. If you notice when I hovered over this, this says representative console. Once again, just to show you, that you can do it a couple different ways. But in order to download that representative console, you can download it here, making sure that you choose the appropriate, bit version and operating system. You can launch the desktop representative from here. It's a couple of items. These are extremely important sections right here, what I'm about to show you. If you are jumping into someone's machine, trying to install software or make changes to their system, you are going to need to be able to elevate your credentials, meaning use your admin rights, okay? And a couple things you're gonna wanna do here. For starters, you're going to want to make sure that you have the representative console, and it's typically 64-bit, at least for the machines here at OSM. But you're going to want to select this and actually download it and go through the installation process. Now, caveat to that, there are a couple of things that you are going to want to do as a part of that process, and I'll show you now. If you come down here and you type in programs, let's see here, and spell, and go to add or remove programs, and come down to BeyondTrust, and you select this, make sure that it says representative at the end of it for the virtual smart card installer, okay? You may have one that says customer, and that is not what you want on your system as an admin. And reason being, each of these installers will basically have confliction between one another, and it won't allow you to appropriately elevate within the system. So if the customer one is in here, you need to make sure you uninstall it and then install the representative console. And it's always advised to reboot where that's concerned. we used to have this basically, you know, as an option for automatic elevation service. You can see that that service has been deprecated and will be removed entirely. You can go through and actually locate it. I have it on my programs from where it was originally put on here, but at any rate, you have that as an option. All right, so I'm not going to actually go through the installation process because that installer is already on machine, but I am going to select my desktop icon and I'm going to show you what it looks like. And just for reference, that's if you had installed this here, this up button here. I'm going to select OK. And I'm going to select Login. And it is not going to function appropriately, which is fine. We can choose the SAML credentials. And it will bring up this is what it started to download. I don't know if you noticed that. Hopefully you did. It just opened to one of the browsers we had open and then started running. But I'm going to simply select that and it's going to open the console. I'm going to give it just a moment to do that. Up off screen. So I'm going to drag this over. And this is the BeyondTrust support representative console. There are quite a few things in here. Not going to go into a crazy deep dive on this video, but did want to at least kind of show you, you know, what you're getting into. The machines that are located here, these are computer numbers, okay, or names rather, you'll hear them referred to as, that you can actually jump into. Now, you typically obviously want to have, you have to have permission, you know, from the client in order to do this. as an example, I was working on this machine yesterday. The last time I accessed it was, again, yesterday afternoon. It's installing a software package on there. But it's pretty simple in terms of actually jumping into the client's machine. You select that, client there, you right click and you select jump. Again, not going to actually do it for the purposes of this video, but wanted to show you. We'll grab some additional videos in the future to be able to help out, you know, to show what you can do there. So, but anyways, hopefully this helps. Hopefully it gives you a little bit of an overview of the BeyondTrust, remote support system that's available for your use. Again, they have some great contract support that can provide, you know, more information as you need it. But again, hopefully this serves as kind of a quick reference guide for your use. Please do not hesitate to reach out if you have any questions. Thank you.